Hi, everybody. This is Ryan Schultz, and this is Metaverse Newscast, where we interview the personalities behind social VR, virtual worlds, and the metaverse. I'm very pleased to have as my guest today Cedar Librarian, who was the winner of the Best Avatar contest at the recent Future Lands Festival held in High Fidelity. And out of, what was it, seven, eight contestants?
I think it was nine.
Nine contestants. He was the winner, and I think you can see why. This is a marvelous parrot. And we are interviewing Cedar in his actual Cedar library. This is the library of clickable books that you can open and read within High Fidelity. Welcome.
Hi.
My first question for you is, could you tell us a bit about your background and how you first got involved with social VR and virtual worlds?
Yes, so I've been doing art and design for over 15 years, some cartoon and smaller media projects, but mostly in graphic design, 3D product modeling, and that sort of thing. But I've always been interested more on the illustration, storytelling, and fantasy side. So I got really interested in libraries several years ago. I was at the Grand Central Library in downtown Los Angeles, and it was such a beautiful library.
Yes.
And that's where my inspiration came. So for years, it's been brewing in me to make a library. And, you know, that's how I got into VR, was how can I create an experience where anybody can come and experience, you know, the library in this context. So this is my take on it.
So how did you feel when you won the contest?
Well, obviously I was very excited. I mean, I was...
Did you celebrate?
Of course. Of course I did. I mean, it was... Well, actually, I had to work that day.
Okay.
It was a busy day for me. I was kind of juggling in real life, and I thought, well, I have to be a part of this. I want to check out... I've never been to an event with several, you know, hundreds of people. So, you know, I was there. It was laggy. You know, I was trying to make sure I was at the right place at the right time, even to be in the contest. And then my mind was just distracted. So when I won, I was completely surprised. I didn't really even consider it would happen. Yeah, I was just really elated. It was great. So
that's wonderful. How long did it take for you to make this mask?
Yeah, well, I actually modeled the parrot many years ago. And then the way it kind of happened was... when they announced the Future Lands contest, I was really busy with real world work, and I was kind of like, oh shoot, I want to be a part of this. So I just kind of grabbed this guy. I had already been rigging him for High Fidelity anyways, so I just kind of finished him real quick and like submitted him, because I had to have something to submit.
Okay.
And so
the parts that I really like are like your eyes are rigged and they move around, and your feathers move around, and you've got like index feathers, which I think is so cool.
Thank you.
And even the feather on the top of your hat is flexible. What was the most challenging part about making this avatar?
Well, you know, my first avatar is Binky Dragon. That's what most people have seen me wearing. And that was a challenge because the documentation's a little out of date, and, you know, there's just differences between Blender and High Fidelity. So trying to get it all to fit was a bit difficult.
Okay.
Once I kind of muscled through that, this guy was actually pretty easy because, you know, I had figured out the path, you know. What you mentioned, the eyes and the kind of physically... affected bones like the wings here and the feather. Those are really simple. You know, essentially I'm using the High Fidelity default armature that you,
The one on mine.
You're exactly. And then you just add a string of bones, named a certain way. And if you name it a certain way, you can use their, flow.js script to then add this effect. There's an app that will help you to use sliders and set how springy, how much the weight affects it, how stiff it is, and then you copy a little bit of code into that flow.js script. Very simple to use.
Do you need to know a lot about JavaScript in order to do this?
Not at all. Okay. In fact, if you know even a little bit, essentially, you know, like I said, there's a app that they give you, and you can use sliders to kind of test the springiness.
Once
you have it the way you want it, you copy a little bit of code, you open up the JavaScript, and it actually is marked off in comments, like, put your custom script here, it ends here. You know, so as long as you know a little bit enough to do that much, it's actually super simple. So I don't want to take credit for this. I didn't script all this.
Okay. Well, it's still a very amazing presentation.
Thank you. And also, I don't want to take credit for the eyes as well. As long as you rig it properly, and also the facial movements, they have it attached to your audio. So as long as you name your shape keys correctly and, you know, rig your eyes properly, or, well, in my case, eye, you know, it should work with their default animations. So,
okay. Mm-hmm. Can you tell us what software tools did you use to create your prize-winning avatar?
Oh, this guy.
Yes.
So, I actually used Blender 3D for the modeling, and actually a lot of the painting as well. And then, you know, Photoshop for some things.
Cedar, I was wondering if you could actually pose and show off your avatar for a few seconds.
So this is Piratey Pete Parrot, and this is what he looks like when he flies. And let me just turn around for you, give you a little bit of this deliciousness. So
I love the eye patch.
Thank you. So his hands are the top feather here. And actually, here, let me just turn around a little bit in real life so I'm oriented properly for my sensors. But these top feathers are his hands, and they work similar to mitts, but they do have finger and thumb abilities here, and so there is hand bones within this, you know, within these fully articulate, so I can pick things up, and, you know,
cool.
Yeah, just like normal. And then I have a little bit of tail wiggle, head wiggle with the feather. And I'm not sure how close you are to see, but his mouth does move and his eye blinks. So, yeah. And this is kind of a more...
Oh, wow.
Supposed to be kind of a space adventurer, part animal person.
Wow.
Twirl around. Let's go do a slow turn.
Is that slow enough, or should I go slower?
Slower the other way. Go. Yeah. Great.
Yeah. So this is, I have a working name for this one called Jira Lawrence. And, yeah, she's supposed to be kind of just a cool, smoky, you know, like, character.
That's lovely.
Yeah, thank you.
So what are your future plans for the library?
So Cedar Library already has about 80 books that are live. You can laser beam click them in VR, and it'll open your tablet, and you can read text. We're going to have audiobooks, but what I'm most excited about are our experience books, where each book will be a teleportation into an experience, into possibly other domains.
Like another domain.
Mm-hmm. So, okay. You know, you could perhaps learn about, you know, geometry from Euclid himself as he draws, you know, triangles in the sand on a beach or something like that. Also, you know, we want to have adventures. So that's where we're going with this. I want to have a lot of adventure characters. And, you know, in addition to all the books that I have, this whole island is going to be gamified. So there's going to be little quests and goals and puzzles you can solve. And, and I want characters that fit within that context.
And so, the name of this domain is Cedar Library.
This is Cedar Library, yep.
Okay. Yeah. So tell me, what kinds of things do you see happening on the high fidelity platform in the future to make avatars easier to make and to customize?
Yeah, well, they have really been aggressively, well, I don't know if that's the right word. They've really enthusiastically been trying to incentivize creators.
Yes.
So, you know, that's something that I think is wonderful. You know, I'm already doing, since the contest, I have two commissions moving forward with avatars.
Oh, that's wonderful. Actually, I have to find someone to create a custom avatar for me. I'm wearing the standard issue Matthew avatar with a wizard's hat
I would
attached.
have never known. You
Oh, of course
you're
not.
like doing the Clark Kent thing, you know, totally disguised. And that's kind of what I think High Fidelity is doing right, is they're really trying to connect people who create. They're like fanning the flame and, you know, trying to get us active. And that's what I love about it. So, yeah, I don't know. I feel really good about that.
So why don't you take us to the start of your labyrinth, and we can talk a bit more there, and Andrew can film some more. Can you tell me a little bit about this labyrinth that you're that you are constructing here?
Sure. So this is going to be one of our first puzzle projects where people can come and explore this kind of garden labyrinth. There's going to be little puzzles and clues. There's going to be some peril. We want to make it so that there's some monsters that you can interact with, possibly be eaten by.
Like non-playing characters?
Right.
So, okay. Now, you said we. Are you working on this with somebody else?
I do have some help, for sure. You know, coders, and I'm talking to some other artists who aren't quite on board yet, but, you know, fingers crossed, it's all going to work out. So, yeah, we're trying to make this as fun and exciting and cool as possible.
Let's go around the corner and take a look.
Sure. Yeah.
So is there anything that we haven't touched on yet that you'd like to bring up?
Come to the library, read some books, meet people. We would love to have you.
Okay, there you go. Thank you so much for this, Cedar.
Thank you. It was a pleasure.
And as before, I'm Ryan Schultz, and you're watching Metaverse Newscast.